can step out, get some air now, let your edge out, to some ice, but you'll be heavy in my mind. Hi guys, welcome to my channel and thank you for watching my very first video. So this video I had planned to be like my pre-med journey story and really just who I am so you guys can get to know who's behind this channel. My name is Taryn Dargan. I'm 25 years old. I'm originally from Texas, but I've been living in Boston since 2014. I graduated from Boston College in 2018 and now I am currently at Tufts Med School doing my master's in biomedical sciences. So I just wanted to give you guys a little rundown on like who I am and what made me want to undertake this med school journey. I really just wanted to start this YouTube because as much like intrinsic motivation that I have to get to med school, I need more external motivation. It's been like 10 years in this journey and I'm still not at the med school point yet. And so I'm really looking forward to like documenting my journey going forward and really excited to have you guys come along for the ride. I personally think that I've always known that I wanted to be a doctor, but I asked my mom specifically when I started talking about wanting to be a doctor, and she said probably fourth or fifth grade, which, it could be for a couple different reasons. My great-granduncle is Charles Richard Drew, and I always learned about him growing up as like this pioneer in the medical field and the father of the blood bank. And I definitely wanted to make my contribution to the world just like he did. But also around fourth or fifth grade, I started dealing with my own medical issues, which became a chronic issue. Basically, I had a congenital ankle issue that no podiatrist, no doctors could figure out until my freshman year of high school. And so it was just like chronic pain, constant like frustration. And I remember really thinking that I wish that I had the knowledge and the training to handle this myself. Yes, as a fourth or fifth grader, that's exactly where my mind was going. But I know that I just became really interested in like the human body and how it worked while trying to fix my own problems. So I've always been a healer, and really anything that I can use to heal others or help others heal in their own way, I've been really interested in. So when I was a kid, I always wanted to be the one, you know, using the first aid kit. My brother had an allergy, I always wanted to be the one giving him the EpiPen shot. And I've always just been so infatuated with the human body, and I loved science and reading and all of that, and you know, everything kind of pointed me in the direction of doctor, but I wasn't like 100% sure. But then I've also tried so many jobs in the 25 years that I've been here. And that's kind of confirmed to me that like my place is in the medical field. I've been a technology consultant, I've been a commissioned artist, I've done hair, I've tried to do photography. I'm the COO of Little Lift, I'm wearing the shirt. You guys should subscribe to our channel and follow us. I've babysat, I've done so many different things, and they were all really fulfilling in a certain way, but nothing in the way that like practicing medicine and helping patients really does for me. And then lastly, I feel like as a Black woman, it's really my responsibility to make my own personal change in the medical world. There are just so many disparities and injustices in medicine, across all minorities, but Black people specifically. In the old days, there was misconceptions that Black people didn't even feel pain, and so slaves were operated on, you know, without anesthesia, without pain meds, and a lot of the founding fathers of medicine were experimenting on slaves. There are still very real disparities in 2021 in medicine, especially with Black people, and I know that there's like a general distrust in the medical community amongst Black people, and so I just feel like it's really my responsibility to make strides in medicine to make medicine more accessible to my community. So the ideal path for me would have been to do my 4 years of undergrad, take the MCAT sometime during that time, apply junior year, and be able to go straight from
undergrad to med school, but unfortunately my freshman year of college, I got a very bad concussion during a rugby game. I lost consciousness, and honestly from there on it was like all downhill.
This was a huge setback in terms of grades. I had just started college, and so I was learning how to study, how to manage my time, how to deal with being away from my family all the way across the country, alone, you know, and now I had a debilitating concussion that just wrecked my short-term memory, made me extremely emotional, made me extremely anxious, and it was just so hard to do college, basically. And so I ended up withdrawing from a bunch of classes my freshman year, trying to take things slow, not getting good grades because I was studying all the time, I couldn't remember anything, I was just riddled with anxiety. And this pretty much lasted all the way through fall semester, sophomore year, when I kind of was either like, either I stop this major, which was neuroscience, or I drop out of pre-med, or I don't know, maybe BC is just too hard for me. And so I ended up going to see a neurologist, and I was telling him about my problems. He did some tests, and he ended up suggesting that I go home and take a medical leave for the semester. So I took spring semester off, and I came back in the summer. I was well rested, my brain had healed a lot, and I had, you know, learned a lot about myself in that time, and I just felt like I was ready to come back to BC and really go off on my grades, on my volunteering, everything. So I decided to try and focus on building an upward trend for myself. I knew that with my grades, it was gonna be very hard for me to get into med school now, but I also knew that that was the only path for me. And so something had to shake. I worked on really improving my mental and physical health and my study habits so that I could bring my GPA up. I started working out consistently and eating right, taking care of myself, getting enough sleep. I joined Lift about 4 years ago, and just having to like come up with content and worry about my fitness journey because we were giving out these fitness tips really helped, you know, make it a lifestyle for myself. I also I was so strict, I cut out a lot of the partying, I cut out, you know, a lot of the social time, and I just focused on my grades and what I knew was gonna build up my GPA and hopefully give me a chance to go to med school. I also volunteered and took a lot of leadership positions. My freshman year before my concussion, I actually joined Students Helping Honduras, or SHH, which is an amazing, amazing nonprofit. And by junior year, I was leading multiple groups to Honduras in the winter to build schools, and yeah. I also, while at BC, took an EMT course, and then after graduating, I made up classes I had failed in undergrad or that I didn't get to take because I ran out of time while I worked as an EMT, and just got some real world patient care experience, especially pre-hospital. So I worked as an EMT for a year, and then afterwards I decided that since I had the pre-hospital experience, I was going to try and get an in-hospital experience. And now since I had my EMT license, I was able to work at Tufts Medical Center in their children's hospital as a clinical care technician, first on their med-surg floor and then secondly on their pediatric bone marrow transplant floor, and just gain a lot of real world experience in patient care and empathy and bedside manner, all of that. Currently, I am in my second year of the MBS, Masters of Biomedical Sciences program at Tufts Med School. I had all my classes done out of the way last year during the pandemic, virtual school, yay. But now I'm working in the neuroscience lab of Dr. Jamie McGuire, where I am investigating whether previous stress exposure in mice exacerbates HPA axis dysfunction and possibly worsens seizure outcomes. So stay tuned for how that's going. So while I do this neuroscience research for my thesis, I'm also working and I'm studying for the MCAT, and I'm hoping to take the MCAT next spring in hopes of applying next cycle to med school and hopefully start med school by August of 2023. So I'm very excited about this. I'm excited for this YouTube, and thank you guys so much for watching and for listening. for being interested in my life. Guys, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Let me know what videos you would look forward to.